big banana, would say. Grain to drain.
Morning all. American pale ale again, same recipe as last time. A couple of blokes down the pub want to taste it, so I'll do it again. But also, I want to talk about this. This is supposed to be Voss Gewijk Voss, and I got it off of eBay. I bought two bags. One was used for the Gibb New Bishop's tipple. Well, we're in mourning because I've had to tip it away. It took 30 hours to start, which Voss doesn't take that long, at 35 degrees. And then when it did start, it went through the airlock, which I showed you on the last video. And it smelled and tasted really medicinal and phenolic. So anyway, as Big Banana would say, it's grain to drain, it's gone, it's on its way to the sewer beds. So anyway, back to the APA, just waiting for the temperature, and then I'll let you have a look at the mash. See you soon. Right, mash in. Turn that off a minute. Bit of wheat malt and aromatic malt. There's the lager malt. No lumps in that. Now the pale ale malt. Bit at the time for this one. Yeah, I was gutted about that. Gibb's Mew, Bishop's Tipple. I'd say I won't be getting any more out of eBay. I mean, I didn't even get it because it was cheap. Just one of those random eBay sellers selling Voss. Thought it was going to come in a packet, like an Allemande or something like that, and it came in a little. I was a bit dubious then. Still, can't change it now. It won't be happening again. Thank you. have a look actually. I don't know if you can see that. Yeah, it's coming up. There we go.
There we go. Close it off a bit actually. Bit high at the moment, I don't know why. That'll come down. There we go.
Using the phone to record today because my camera is a decent one. It's getting a bit dirty and I don't want to ruin it, so I'm going to try with the phone. Only a cheap one, it's a Samsung A13, so it's quite old. Well, I ain't had it that long. Right, I'll do a pH. The pH was 6, believe it or not, so I put 3.5 millilitres of phosphoric acid in. So hopefully that'll sort it out.
Going well. 40 minutes to go. Well, 35 minutes to go. I'll bring you back if anything happens. Here's a look at the Cronenberg at the moment. Still bubbling away. This is 7 days. I've just started to ramp up the temperature. Or degree every day, and it's on 17 at the moment. Right. It's going well.
20 minutes to go. All's looking good at the moment. Nothing to report. Mash is doing all right. Nice and clear. Get this one done quick. I'm not doing a no cool this time, no chill. I'm gonna run it through the cooling coil, let it get to about 35, and it's in the airing cupboard again as usual. And hopefully this one's all right. See you soon.
Right, it's nearly mash out time. Sparge water's heating up. You can see that is as clear as a bell. Looking good. Sparge water's up to 70 71, so we'll soon be on 76.
temperature up there is 66. That stayed pretty good throughout. So we'll start sparging in about 5 minutes. Okay, time to start the sparge. Now, I'll turn that off. I'll turn the pump off. Shut that off. And I want that under there. So I'll take this off. This off. Off. This goes on there like that. So it's coming out of there, through here, into here, and round into the boil kettle. So that pump on. The bottom one. And open that round. So this one. Let the water get above the grain. Getting just above the grain. Slow that down a tad. That's it. I'm going to start the pump up. Open that. Make sure that's closed up. And we're going in the boil kettle, draining a bit quick.
Keep it at that. When it's all in the boil kettle, I'll bring you back.